day, none of you would know that I'm not Canadian. Even though I've lived here for 71% of my life, and that's a good enough excuse for anyone who's convinced I'm Canadian to say that I am. But I'm not Canadian, I'm British. One half Welsh, one quarter Scottish, and one quarter English. 0% Canadian. And you may think that after 9 years of living here, I might be used to the Canadian lifestyle, but I'm not. I'm still attached to my country, to my heritage, and no matter which train I ride on, no matter which track I follow, I will always find myself coming back to the old country lanes of Wales and the big, beautiful castles of England and the misty, rolling hills of Scotland. But then again, so what? I'm born in a different country. So what? I don't have the accent. So what? I rarely see my family. So what? At Thanksgiving, I only spend it with 3 other people. So what? On Christmas, my favorite present is a transatlantic Skype call. So what? I'm closer to my Canadian friends here than I am to my family back in the UK. What? Blood is thicker than water, but about 41 million square kilometers of water separate me from my blood. And although I may be an average girl living an almost average life, I'm worrying about my future at only 13 years old because I don't know if I'm going to follow the train tracks that lead me back to my home country or stay in the place where every single string attached to me is tied. My brain is fried, I can't decide, I don't know what to do with myself. I don't know who I am. Am I British or am I Canadian? But wait, think for a moment. Who really is 100% Canadian? Almost all of the families living here have heritage from another country, have ancestors who moved here and made a life here. And although they may not know it, that affects the way they live and the food they eat. And it does not matter how long they've lived here, because the people who've lived here the longest are treated the worst. The people who have lived here for centuries have a 7 times higher suicide rate than you and me. And the people who are really the only ones that can say that they are Canadian aren't treated like Canadians. 60% of First Nations live in poverty. What have the Canadians done about it? And this year, on July 1st, marks 150 years since this country was born. But is that really true? People have lived on this land for centuries before that, but now they're just forgotten. A lost piece of history floating in the wind, just waiting to be found in our school textbooks. So please forgive me when I say, I don't really know what it means to be Canadian, so how can I know that I'm not? So many people don't understand me when I say that Canada is where I live, and although I love it here, the UK is my home. But I'm not asking you to understand, I'm asking you to listen. Because saying that I'm Canadian isn't listening to my heart, because my heart will always pump British blood. And saying that I'm Canadian is cutting off my circulation, stopping me from breathing, stopping me from living my life, stopping me from being me. Don't try to take away my identity. I'm British, not Canadian, and no one can tell me otherwise.